Christmas to you guys. Happy Yule. Happy holidays, whatever is appropriate for you. We're going to be looking at the Aries, the Taurus, and the Gemini in this video. We're going to obviously start with the Aries. We're going in zodiac order. So the timestamps will be at the bottom. So I did it like this for a reason, okay? Because of the zodiac order. So I wanted to do it this way. I'm going to be using the Druidcraft tarot deck for this reading. So we're going to look at love in December, okay? And we're going to go ahead and start with the Aries. For those of you that are new to the channel, make sure that you hit that subscribe button. The link to my website is below if you are in need of any spiritual services, spiritual work. The link is below, okay? All right, let's go ahead and get started here. I'm going to call to the spirit guides, ancestors, messengers, guardian angels for the Aries, sun, moon, rising. Okay, what are you seeing for the singles? So we're going to look at for the singles. We're going to look and see if anybody is coming in, okay? And this could also be for people that are involved too. So, you know, but if you're single looking for love, then we're going to start off with you single Aries looking for love, okay? Spirit guides, ancestors, guardian angels. Who are you seeing? What are you seeing going on for the single Aries currently? Anything relevant from the past? And what are you seeing happening in December of 2018? Okay, anyone coming in, any new lovers for the single Aries, sun, moon, and rising? All right, so let's see what's going on here. All right, so for the single Aries, for December, I'm not really seeing anybody come in December. I feel as though I can see somebody coming in after the first of the year, but unfortunately in December, I feel as though a lot of you are still thinking about a lover from the past. What comes up in the current position is the Princess of Pentacles. So I feel like right now at the moment, a lot of you Aries are sort of, you're busy with work. There may also be an earth, fire, or a air sign in the past. Spirit, give me some clarity on current. Okay. Yeah. So a lot of you singles, you've definitely got an air, I'm sorry. You definitely have either an earth, a fire sign that you're dealing with right now. The moon card comes up in the reverse position, so there's a lot of fear surrounding moving on. I can definitely see a lover that has a very powerful, strong effect over you. clarify the King of Swords from the past, please? Okay, yeah, the Six of Pentacles is in the reverse position. So some of you have an air sign that they just really did not. They were sort of exploiting you. Maybe they were exploiting you financially. I can just see an air sign exploiting you financially in the past. This air sign, what spirit is telling me is that it could have been your mother-in-law, or it could have been like your, you know, or either your lover, your ex-lover. Clarify, Queen of Wands, please. Okay, yeah, King of Cups reversed. So somebody was not, Queen of Pentacles reversed and Five of Pentacles reversed. So there was some cheating. Feel like a lot of you Aries that are single now, you got hurt really bad in the past. I can definitely see a friend of yours betraying you, you know, and things just not going well. I can see in particular a love triangle where somebody possibly cheated with a friend, and you were not let in on it until like sort of like the tail end. So you felt really left out in the cold during that time. It was either something or it wasn't. For some of you Aries, it was just kind of like a put on or a lie from your ex. If for your ex to play games like that, they're obviously very insecure. Now for December, what I can see is the Four of Cups and then the Rebirth card. So I kind of feel as though during the month of December, I can see a lot of you Aries just really not being in the best place when it comes to love. Unfortunately, as far as like with new love, I can definitely see just sort of not being in a good place emotionally for love in December. Unfortunately, Spirit, give me some clarity on the Four of Cups. So with that type of energy, of course, there's probably not going to be anybody that's going to come in. The Nine of Pentacles comes up. So I feel as though Spirit is saying that if you feel better about yourself to just kind of go out there and do it, then maybe perhaps, but maybe not December, maybe by January or either February. I can definitely see a lot of you Aries that are single just being in a place where you kind of want to wait, but I do see the love bug hitting you possibly sometime in February around Valentine's. But I kind of feel as though you would almost have to sort of, you know, build your confidence back up or whatever, because I can definitely see a lover that is just really having a lot of negative impact, an ex-lover that's tormenting you. Also, for some of you Aries, it's your mother. Could be your mother or either your mother-in-law. Clarify the Rebirth card, Spirits, for the Aries singles. Okay. Yeah. Prince of Pentacles comes up in the reverse position. So I can definitely see, yeah, I can see a lover coming in somewhere after the new year, going up to February, March, but it could also go up into next year, like around June or July. Okay. All right. So Aries, we are going to move on. Definitely can see a fire sign person, either an earth sign person, fire sign person for the singles. I'm sorry, I meant to tell you guys that. Either a fire sign person. Yeah. All right, spirit guides, ancestors, guardian angels for the Aries that are in relationships. Show me what is going on currently for Aries lovers. Anything relevant from the past, and what are you seeing for the month of December 2018 for the Aries in relationships? So this is Aries that are in love, for those of you that got you a boo. Okay. Alrighty. Okay. So So, Aries, you've got the Two of Cups in the reverse position coming up at current. What's in the past is the Princess of Wands and the Ten of Pentacles. And then what is coming up in December is the Ten of Cups and the Cernunnos card in the reverse position, though. So, first of all, with the Two of Cups coming up in the reverse position, I feel as though you and your lover currently are sort of having some problems. Definitely some emotional stuff that's hitting you is what I can definitely see for a lot of you. Some sort of obstacle that's happening at the moment. You know, Spirit, clarify Two of Cups reversed. Why is the Two of Cups reversed? Okay, yeah, the Ace of Cups comes up. So there's some sort of problem. And then I can see the birth of a child. I can see the birth of a child, or either it's moving in together, or either some sort of project that was being done together because of the Ten of Pentacles in the past. So I can definitely see a birth of a child. For some of you Aries, your significant other could have went and had a child with another person. So the Ten of Pentacles comes up, as well as the Princess of Wands. But I will tell you that I can definitely see a completion happening. Either there was a, you know, maybe somebody, it was some kind of commitment. Even possibly a birth of a child that I can see for a lot of you Aries. Now for December, the Ten of Cups comes up. So this is representing happiness and completion. But the Cernunnos card comes up in the reverse position, which means that there's an energy, there's a negative bad energy attachment. I want to clarify what this is. Spirit, give me some clarity on the Cernunnos card. So the Ten of Cups is a very good sign. Okay, so this Queen of Wands right here. Yeah, these are some people. Oh, wow. Okay, so three people came out, Aries. Queen of Wands, Queen of Swords, and King of Cups reversed. These are three people that are obsessed with you. They seem to have some sort of unhealthy obsession. And you can definitely see them in the month of December with the Four of Pentacles. I feel like they're either trying to possibly rob you of something, take something. They're trying to take something in December. They're trying to take something away. You can see where you and your lover in the month of December, in particular around Yule and Christmas time, I can see a lot of happiness, especially around that time is when that energy is going to kick in. I can see about the 24th, which I believe the 24th is Christmas Eve or something like that. So I can definitely see on Christmas Eve somebody trying some stuff. You know, they're just sort of obsessive. Let me ask Spirit to what advice to give to the Aries. Okay, so the Hanged Man comes up in the upright position. And so I feel like the Hanged Man represents, you know, you need to, your energy is being sacrificed. You need to pay close attention to these people in December, and you need to do something about them, okay? Because what they're gonna do, I can see that they are going to cause some issues with your relationship going towards the new year. So I can see Christmas is being okay. Like I said, the energy kicks in from these people around the 24th. And you can see it sort of having some issue with whoever these folks are. Okay, it could be your boss. It could be your ex-lover. It could be your mother-in-law. It's going to be different for different ones of you, okay? So I can definitely see that coming up. All right, Aries. Like I said, if you guys need to reach me, the link to my website is below. And I'm going to move on to the Tauruses. All right, Taurus. So I am going to start with your singles reading. If you Tauruses need to reach me for your own private readings or either a consultation for spiritual work, such as cleanses, healings. I was about to say clillings. Cleanses, healings, love work, hex removals. The link is below, okay? Spirit guides, ancestors, guardian angels, messengers for the Tauruses, the single Tauruses. Okay, what messages do you have? What are you saying for current, past, and future in December? Are you seeing a new lover coming in for the Taurus, sun, moon, and rising for December 2018? All right, so we're going to see if there's a new lover that's coming in. So a lot of the cards came up inverted. The tower in the reverse position is what comes up for current. So I can sense for a lot of you single Tauruses that there was a change just recently. Some sort of displacement. Some sort of displacement having to do with a relationship. And the displacement was really, really devastating. I really do feel that, you know. I'm going to clarify exactly what the tower is. I feel like there was some sort of traumatic event having to do with a relationship. Either somebody moved out or somebody got kicked out. Clarify the tower reverse. This is a sudden end to a relationship is what I can see going on currently. Yeah, the Queen of Pentacles is in the reverse position. Yeah. Yeah, and then the Five of Cups. So there's a lot of anger at the moment. You can tell that the single Tauruses are going through, or maybe this Queen of Pentacles could be an aspect of yourself, or maybe it could be your lover. You've got the Fool card reversed and the Eight of Swords reversed. So you were really putting all of your trust into this person, Taurus, and they kind of threw you out there. They did. You were putting a lot of your trust into this person. And, you know, you were really, really not seeing this person for who they were. So this is somebody that's either, could be any zodiac sign, earth, air, fire, or water. Now, you've got the Seven of Cups in the reverse position for December 2018 and the Strength card upright. That Strength card could be an indication of a Leo lover coming into your life, but I doubt that you'd be paying much attention to them because you're carrying a lot of baggage in December. So let me clarify this Seven of Cups reversed. Yeah, Four of Pentacles because you're holding on. I feel like there's an unhealthy attachment to this person. You need to possibly, you know, maybe get a cord cutting or a cleanse. I couldn't imagine feeling this way, you know, especially kicking in on Christmas Eve. I don't know why I'm seeing that for a lot of people. Maybe that's why I did these in groups, but spirit advice for the Four of Pentacles and the Seven of Cups. The Eight of Wands comes up. So I feel as though the spirits are encouraging you to, you know, not be stuck in some kind of emotional slump. You know, to get out there and make yourself feel better. You know, maybe go out and take some walks, you know, to get things going. I feel like spirits is saying to not rush it. You know, you don't need to rush to move on, but you definitely do want to start to move forward. Because I feel like this is probably something for a lot of you Tauruses, that could have been over for a while, and you've really had enough time to process it. Okay, clarify the Strength card, please. So the Strength card is the card for December as well. Okay, so see, there's a fire sign coming in, but you're having a hard time starting over with this person. I can see either an Aries, Leo, or a Sagittarius. For a lot of you, it's going to be a Leo. They're going to be definitely attracted to you. They're definitely going to want you in the month of December. And they're definitely going to want to spend time with you. But I feel as though you're going to have a hard time, you know, towards moving on from them, because you're feeling that baggage in December. So, advice on the Ace of Cups. And then we'll move on to the Taurus lovers. Okay. See the Feralit. And you know, what you need to do is, Taurus, is you need to sort of like redecorate. First of all, there's some objects. I feel like there's either some underwear or some socks from your ex-lover that you need to go ahead and get rid of. But then again, I feel like you create your own environment. You need to like give yourself a pick-me-up, because you're really sort of, you know, you're really not, you know, standing in your power. And then I also feel as though, you know, because the Feralit in the upright position is about creating harmony around you. And in the reverse position, it's sort of like the opposite to that. It's where things are sort of disorganized. So I say maybe do some organization, you know, maybe do some feng shui to your house to make yourself feel better. You know, maybe put up a Christmas tree. Don't do the bah humbug thing, okay? Because you can celebrate Christmas as a single person. You know, it brings, in fact, that joy is what's going to bring love into your life. So I can definitely see a Leo coming in, but I feel as though you may just sort of overlook it, because you're still holding on, you know, to the past. So, all right. We're going to move on to the Taurus lovers. All right, Taurus lovers, those of you that are in relationships, Tauruses that are in relationships, whatever kind of relationship you're in, okay? All right, spirit guides, ancestors, guardian angels, messengers for the Taurus, sun, moon, and rising. Okay, what are you seeing going on current for the Taurus lovers? Anything relevant from the past? And what are you seeing in December of 2018 for the Taurus lovers? All right, I have your answer. All right, so the Feralit comes up at the current. So I feel like there is a lot of harmony and balance between the two of you right now. The rebirth card, I can see there were some problems in the past, in the recent past. Either a water sign, Scorpio, something about a Scorpio, or either an air sign. There was some issues going on in the relationship, some sort of fear, because the nine, so I can see a lot of arguments and just not seeing eye to eye on things. But I feel like at the current, as we go into December, things are going good. Now in December, you guys got the Six of Swords reversed and the Ten of Swords upright. So right off the bat, when I saw that Six of Swords, I thought, oh, okay, somebody must be moving in December. Or either maybe it's, you know, metaphorically. But then this Ten of Swords comes up. So I need to do some more clarifying. Spirit, give me some clarity on the Six of Swords. Because, because it's a Swords and it's reversed, we need to definitely clarify it. Card fallen. Okay, Three of Swords comes up. So I feel as though this is a third party that's outside of the relationship that's causing problems. They've caused problems in the past, and they seem to be causing problems in December. I can definitely see the relationship trying to work itself out in the month of December, but it's choking. It's choking with this Three of Swords, okay? Definitely can see some disappointment surrounding moving or moving plans that a lot of you Tauruses may be making. I can possibly see some disappointment, and see that can cause problems. It's got something to do with either credit or some sort of stipulation or something having to do with your current person's ex. Maybe there's something that's been added to the credit or something. Some kind of disappointment surrounding moving in the month of December. Let me clarify Ten of Swords. Spirits, give me some clarity on the Ten of Swords. As a matter of fact, I can see a lot of you Tauruses unfortunately having some issues. Yeah, the Eight of Swords comes up. So there's definitely some issues in your relationship in the month of December. All Swords cards, the Six of Swords reversed, the Three of Swords upright, and then the Ten of Swords, and then the Eight of Swords. Okay, both upright. So there is definitely some kind of negativity that's going to come up in the relationship. It's going to start probably like the first week of December. I can see it. Yeah. And definitely there being some unhappiness in the relationship. So unfortunately, I'm sorry about that, Taurus, that I can see that. Let me ask for advice. Spirits, what advice do you want to give to Tauruses on their relationship in December? Okay, well, the Three of Wands is in the reverse position. So what I can tell you is that I can definitely see a third party. And I can definitely see whoever your lover is having a really hard time getting their mind off of this person. It's either their ex, or it's either somebody that they could possibly be cheating with. Okay? And then I also kind of feel like this may be sort of an open relationship, maybe. Definitely can see some disappointment in December. Definitely can see some disappointment starting around the 23rd, as far as when it comes to Christmas, as far as like with the holidays, is what I can see. Okay, so I feel like what spirits want you to do is they want you to, what the Three of Wands is saying is for you possibly to go, hey, listen, something's gonna have to give. Okay. All right, I'm going to move on to the Geminis. Hello, Gemini. All right, let's get started with the gems. Okay. Spirit guides, ancestors, guardian angels for the single Geminis. Okay, Gemini, if you need to reach me, the link to my website is below. I do offer phone, video, and Skype readings and consultations. If you guys are looking for rituals and spells that work, you can contact me at the link below. Okay, all right, spirit guides for the Gemini sun, moon, and rising. Okay, what are you seeing for the singles, current? Okay, anything relevant from the past? And then what are you seeing in the future? Okay, for December, any lovers coming in? What are the love energies for Gemini in December 2018? All right. Okay, so let's see what's going on here. All right, so in the current position, you Geminis got the Ace of Wands. So I feel like right now, currently, you're ready to move forward. The Queen of Swords and the Eight of Cups is in the past, so you can definitely see that there was a relationship that either had to have been, you know, the relationship was abandoned, it was over. I feel like you walked away from it. Okay, it was a relationship with an air sign, and so this could either be another person or it could be yourself and you're deciding to start over. Because there are some people that have never been in relationships before. And maybe this could be your first relationship, okay? So, now in December, the Four of Pentacles reverse comes up and the Prince of Wands comes up reversed. So, I definitely feel like the single Geminis, as far as like with your love life, I feel like you haven't really complete. I feel like there's an unhealthy attachment that you have. I don't feel like you're necessarily ready to move on in December. Spirit guides, give me some clarity on the Four of Pentacles reverse. Yeah, the Princess of Wands comes up. definitely can see that there is a fire sign that seems to be pursuing you, Gemini. But I feel like you're not really returning that person's phone calls. Okay, I feel like you are in a place where you're just not really caring much about love. Kind of not really being in the holiday spirit either. So what is the holiday spirit? I think that the holiday spirit is just feeling really warm and comforted, and it's just something special because there's going to be people giving out gifts and there's going to be people that are going to be drinking eggnog and apple cider. It's just like a joyous spirit is basically what holiday cheer is about. And it's about you know, also you know, the winter solstice and Yule. So and it's about family togetherness or celebration, if you want to say, you know. So clarify the Prince of Wands. Yeah, your energy is not focused on love in December. Yeah, you're more so focused on self. The Princess of Swords comes up. I feel like you're more so focused on self. Okay, and then the Lady comes up. So I feel like I can definitely see some abundance coming. Now, some of you, there possibly could be an earth sign individual coming in that you may possibly be interested in. I kind of think that this, whoever this Princess of Wands is, they're just kind of throwing themselves at you. So I don't really think that you're that into them in the month of December. But I can definitely see you possibly looking at the Lady, and I can see a person, they may or may not have children. I can definitely see them as being financially established and that being something that you're attracted to, you know. But I get the sense, let me throw an advice, that a lot of you don't need to just be attracted to money because it's the stability that you're looking for. But you want to make sure that everything is the total package. Okay, you don't want to go into something that you don't really, yeah, see the Six of Pentacles comes up. So make sure that it's not just about the finances and the money. Make sure that that person has other qualities that you're looking for in a partner, okay? Because money definitely can make you, and money does make you feel good, but not just that. You know, you want to make sure that you mesh well together, okay? All right, so the Gemini lovers, spirit guides, ancestors, guardian angels, what are you seeing for the Gemini sun, moon, and rising? For the lovers, okay, for their love relationships, marriages, commitments, what's going on current? Okay, anything relevant from the past? And what are you seeing in the future in December of 2018 for the Gemini lovers? Uh-oh, cards are just kind of falling here. Oh, shoot. Okay, Gemini. Nine of Swords and the Six of Swords falls out. So that's probably sort of the energies that you're dealing with now. Or that could be sort of in the future or in December. Okay. Let's see what we got here. I'm still going to throw a card for current. Yeah. Definitely can see that's what you're experiencing now. There's definitely some sort of either mental healing or emotional healing that is taking place at the moment. The Nine of Swords comes up, which represents possible depression, you know, possibly not sleeping. Six of Swords comes up, and I feel like this represents a lot of you Geminis, you know, possibly wanting to either move physically, like move physically, or you want to get your mind off of whatever the heck it is. Okay. The Four of Swords in the reverse position is representing, you know, being really isolated or, you know, maybe suffering some kind of illness. Okay. Now, I will tell you that I feel like right now a lot of you Geminis in your relationship, you're sort of split apart. You're sort of split up. You really are. There was a lot of plans that was being made. Now, you can see where there was a plan to make to either to buy a house or move in together. The Cernunnos card comes up, which represents the Devil, which represents some sort of unhealthy attachment. So you can see these plans being made in the relationship, Gemini, but it's something's actually not happening. Clarify Cernunnos. Okay, so the Ace of Wands comes up reversed. It's definitely got something to do with trying to move on from a fire sign. It could be some baggage that's coming from a fire sign, or coming from your bloodline or your family. Okay, so Gemini, in December, you guys get the Six of Wands and the Ten of Wands for the lovers. So your lover, I feel, is really, really going to come through for you. Even though right now there's some difficulty, in December, they're going to, it's going to be some kind of reunion in December. And I can also see them sort of, you know, standing up, because the Six of Wands, you know, it represents courage, you know, having to lead. So I can definitely see some, you know, in the relationship, you know, something coming together. Right now there's a problem. You can see that there's an issue. Spirit, give me some clarity on the Six of Wands. Okay, so the Six of Pentacles comes up reversed. So I feel as though it was sort of where, you know, somebody's trying to sort of make amends for something, because there was somewhere where your lover was falling short. Okay. I don't know what that was that felt like. It wasn't a spider or something. The Ten of Wands comes up though, but I do feel as though I can see the relationship coming together in the month of December. There's definitely some burden that's coming, I feel, from either the family, work, or either your ex-in-laws, one or the other. So there is some sort of burden. But the Ten of Wands, it just looking at the relationship, it does represent a completion, and it does represent your lover having your back. Clarify the Ten of Wands. Yeah, so Geminis, you guys, like I said, yep, the Eight of Swords comes up reversed. So there is... You know, the Eight of Swords in the reverse position is actually very positive. actually very positive. Okay. I'm going to ask for final advice for the Gemini lovers. Like I said, if you guys need to reach me for a phone video or Skype reading or consultation, the link to my website is below. Okay, I do accept all major forms of credit and debit cards, including PayPal. Okay, so, all right. Final advice for the Gemini lovers. Okay, so the Ace of Swords comes up, and it was in the reverse position. But the Ace of Swords comes up. So I can see where the, you know, I can see the positive in it coming up in reverse. Because I feel like it was an issue to where, you know, maybe the relationship was going to end. And I don't see that as happening. So, and I really feel like in the month of December, there's going to be a reunion. Definitely a reunion between you and this person. Okay. Thank you so much for watching, Geminis. Love and light to you guys, and namaste.